Hey guys, it's Subharaj back again with another lesson video this week. This week I worked with a student on this jazz standard called Fly Me to the Moon. It's like one of the most well-known ones that a lot of people work on when they're just starting off with jazz. And I sort of ended up coming up with a little bit of like a solo guitar arrangement kind of a thing for him. Where of course like I gave him a basic idea about how I want him to go about it and then play around with that, right? So I thought I'd just like share that basic idea with you. Of course I'm not going to, as usual, I'm not going to play everything exactly the same all the time because I don't really like the whole patternized way of going about it. But having said that, I am following the original form of the song and I'll be doing it in the key of C major. So it starts with A minor, right? So firstly, I would probably break the song into sections and we're gonna work on the first A section. The melody for that is, now notice the exact finger pattern that I'm doing here. I'm doing that for a reason, because the chord voicings that I'm going to use to harmonize this melody will require this kind of a finger pattern. So let's start that again, okay? So I'm holding the C note. C is the first note of the melody. And the first chord of the tune is an A minor chord. C is already a chord tone of that. We just need two more notes to make it an A minor chord and harmonize the note as well. So I'm going to use the root over here, the A, and the flat 3, the C over here. So then it lands on a D minor and I'm just using a D minor triad here. So then it goes to a G dominant 7. I'm using this particular voicing. And then lands on that C major 7. So again. When we go to the next part, which starts with an F chord. And instead of an F major 7th, I'm using an F major 6 here. B flat minor 7 flat 5. E dominant, A minor 7th, A dominant 7th. So, and the melody is, so if I play the two sections together, if I try to play that a little bit more in time, I could be like, and so on, right? And then we go into the B section, which starts with, right? Now again, I am not playing the melody exactly the way you might hear your favorite singers or players play it, because the whole point of jazz improvisation is interpretation. So I'm interpreting this melody in this particular manner, right? So again, so let's do this part first. So this part of the melody lands on the D minor chord. There's like a 2-5. which deceptively goes to another 2-5. So we have D minor to G7. Now obviously you are noticing that I'm not playing D minor and G7 per se. That's because I'm playing different versions of the chord just to spice things up a little bit more. Like in this particular case, I am essentially playing the upper structure of a D minor 7th add 4. And here I'm playing the upper structure of a G dominant 7 with a 13. So when I just play these upper structures by themselves, right, and with the melody, so again, now when I'm going to the next part of that melody, I'm using the same upper structure for an E minor chord as well, and then for the A altered, I'm using an upper structure of an A dominant 7 flat 13, and I'm adding the root on top, which also sort of makes it like an augmented triad, because here, you know, the absolute top part of the chord is an augmented triad. So if I play the whole section, then that's the first repeat of the whole thing. So if I play whatever we worked on so far, we have, then it goes to the second repeat, which is almost the same as the first repeat, where you start with "Fill my heart with song, let me stay forever." So that's the part we're talking about, right? So same as the first repeat so far, then exactly same as the first repeat, then still the same, this is where things change a little bit, okay? So explain too much about what I did there, rather I would have you try and play these, observe, look at this video that I'm making for you, observe what I'm playing, the way I'm playing it, then try to sort of embellish it the way you want to, but in the process also try and see why these voicings that I'm using are working with the melody. And it would also be a great idea to have at least the ideal chord chart, or like maybe a lead sheet of the tune with you, so that you can analyze the chords as well as the melody while you play it. Like maybe once you learn this, you can look at the actual lead sheet and the chord chart and see why what I'm playing works. Because the thing is, in my experience, one of the main reasons why a lot of students struggle to improve is because they don't observe. So it's really important to work on your observation skills if you're trying to learn, because believe me, that's like one of the greatest skills you can really have. So yeah, I'll play the whole thing and have fun. So here it goes. Thank you. Messages, it's time for me to get back to teaching. If you want to take private lessons, my details are below in description. So yeah, hit me up. Always down to give one-on-one lessons, online or offline if you're based in Calcutta. So yeah, I'll be back with another video next week. Hopefully this was helpful. If you observed a few things that you liked, disliked, comment down below. Let's have a chat. Let's have a healthy chat. Okay? So, all right. See you. See you next week.